Hello and welcome to the Tower of London and to the Chapel Royal of St Peter ad Vincula on this Advent Sunday. Welcome to you wherever you are in the world and wherever you're listening to this service. Today is Advent Sunday. My beloved in Christ, on this Advent Sunday let us prepare ourselves for the celebration of Christ's Nativity, as also for the day when he shall come to judge the hearts of us all. In word and in music, we will give voice to the hope set forth in the Holy Scriptures, that God's kingdom will come, and with John the Baptist and all the saints and the Blessed Virgin Mary, we will prepare for its coming, celebrating its dawning in the birth, life and death of our Lord and Saviour, Jesus Christ. With confidence in the God who saves us, we examine our preparation for death and eternal life, in order that we might be strengthened in hope, moved to thank him for his grace, and inspired to deeper penitence and greater love. Advent shares with Lent the spirit of restraint, preparation, and penitence, as again we prepare with expectant longing for the coming of Christ's kingdom in power and the spirit of penitence which that engenders. To help us to do that, we have our Advent wreath, which reminds us of the patriarchs, the prophets, John the Baptist, and Mary, the mother of our Lord. And so, I will light the first of our candles on the Advent wreath. Let us pray. Sovereign Lord, God of our ancestors, to you be praise and glory forever. You call the patriarchs to live by the light of faith and to journey in the hope of your promised fulfilment. May we be obedient to your call and ready and watchful to receive your Christ, a lamp to our feet and a light to our path. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Of grace, of God's gifts. The Old Testament reading is taken from the book of Exodus, chapter 3, verses 1 to 6. Now Moses kept the flock of Jethro, his father-in-law, the priest of Midian. And he led the flock to the backside of the desert and came to the mountain of God, even to Horeb. And the angel of the Lord appeared unto him in a flame of fire out of the midst of a bush. And he looked, and behold, the bush burned with fire, and the bush was not consumed. And Moses said, I will now turn aside and see this great sight, why the bush is not burned. And when the Lord saw that he turned aside to see, God called unto him out of the midst of the bush and said, Moses, Moses. And he said, Here am I. And he said, Draw not nigh hither. Put off thy shoes from off thy feet, for the place whereon thou standest is holy ground. Moreover, he said, I am the God of thy father, the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob. And Moses hid his face, for he was afraid to look upon God. Thanks be to God.
Thank you. reading from Isaiah chapter 22, beginning at verse 21. And I will clothe him with thy robe, and strengthen him with thy girdle. And I will commit thy government into his hand. And he shall be a father to the inhabitants of Jerusalem, and to the house of Judah. And the key of the house of David will I lay upon his shoulder, so he shall open, and none shall shut, and he shall shut, and none shall open. And I will fasten him as a nail in a sure place, and he shall be for a glorious throne to his father's house. And they shall hang upon him all the glory of his father's house, the offspring and the issue, all vessels of small quantity, from the vessels of cups even to all the vessels of flagons. In that day, saith the Lord of hosts, shall the nail that is fastened in the sure place be removed, and be cut down, and fall, and the burden that was upon it shall be cut off, for the Lord hath spoken it. Thanks be to God.
Reading from Matthew's Gospel, chapter 1, beginning to read at verse 18. Now the birth of Jesus Christ was on this wise, when as his mother Mary was espoused to Joseph, before they came together, she was found with a child of the Holy Ghost. Then Joseph, her husband, being a just man, and not willing to make her a public example, was minded to put her away privily. But while he thought on these things, behold, the angel of the Lord appeared unto him in his dream, saying, Joseph, thou son of David, fear not to take unto thee Mary thy wife, for that which is conceived in her is of the Holy Ghost. And she shall bring forth a son, and thou shalt call his name Jesus, for he shall save his people from their sins. Now all this was done that it might be fulfilled which was spoken of the Lord by the prophet, saying, Behold, a virgin shall be with child, and shall bring forth a son, and they shall call his name Emmanuel, which being interpreted is God with us. Thanks be to God.
A reading from St. Luke's Gospel, chapter 1, beginning to read from verse 39. And Mary arose in those days and went into the hill country with haste into a city of Judah, and entered into the house of Zacharias and saluted Elizabeth. And it came to pass that when Elizabeth heard the salutation of Mary, the babe leapt in her womb, and Elizabeth was filled with the Holy Ghost. And she spake out with a loud voice and said, Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb. And whence is this to me, that the mother of my Lord should come to me? For, lo, as soon as the voice of thy salutation sounded in mine ears, the babe leapt in my womb for joy. And blessed is she that believed, for there shall be a performance of those things which were told her from the Lord. And Mary said, My soul doth magnify the Lord, and my spirit hath rejoiced in God my Saviour. For he hath regarded the low estate of his handmaiden. For, behold, from henceforth all generations shall call me blessed. For he that is mighty hath done to me great things, and holy is his name. Thanks be to God.
Advent is an important season. It's more than just a kind of pause before Christmas. The liturgical colour is penitential purple, and there is a parallel with Lent, the fasting month before Easter. Just as Lent is an important time of preparation for the glories of Easter, Advent too is an important season in its own right. Advent means coming. Advent is the part of the church year in which we concentrate particularly on the fact that God did come to dwell amongst us as a human being, born of Mary, and that he will return. He will come again. That is what we mean by the second coming. The second coming is not just a nice idea dreamt up by the church. It's not as if the disciples turned to Jesus and said, Thank you for coming, do come again. Our Lord himself told us that he would return. As we say in the Creed, he shall come again to judge both the quick and the dead. Are we ready for that judgment? That said, there is no denying that Advent this year is unlike any that most of us have known. Things are grim. Furthermore, at the start of this new church year, we're all of us probably aware that in the past 12 months, we may have fallen short of our own intentions and also fallen short of God's reasonable expectations of us as members of his church. We may not have given as much of our time, talents, and resources as we could have done. We may not have treated our fellows as well as we should. We may have neglected our duties as members of the Christian community and ambassadors for Christ in wider society. Especially in light of the coronavirus pandemic, we may even have thought that the world, and our lives perhaps, were in such a hopeless mess that there was nothing to be done about it. We may have lost hope. Well, we cannot turn the clock back, but that is no cause for simply shrugging or giving in to despair. We can do better in the future. Many people make resolutions for the 1st of January. We could make resolutions at the start of our church year, today, Advent Sunday. The message that we can take from Mary's words in today's gospel is a message of determination and steadfastness in the face of adversity. We cannot know when the second coming will occur, in our earthly lifetimes or 1,000 years hence. The parlous state of the world may tempt us to give up and simply not bother to struggle for the light and the truth. But we should perhaps count our blessings. We have Mary's inspired song to guide us how to act now as we wait not passively but actively as servants of God, not simply waiting but working for the coming of the kingdom. Not merely consuming, but contributing our time, talents, and resources to our own Christian community, and through it to the universal Church of Christ and to the wider world. May this Advent be for all of us a time of renewal, a renewal of faith, hope, and love. Amen.
Watch and pray that you may be ready for the coming of Christ. The Collect for Advent Sunday. Almighty God, give us grace that we may cast away the works of darkness and put upon us the armour of light, now in the time of this mortal life in which thy Son, Jesus Christ, came to visit us in great humility, that in the last days, when he shall come again in his glorious majesty, to judge both the quick and the dead, we may rise to the life immortal, through him who liveth and reigneth with thee and the Holy Ghost, now and for ever. Amen. Watch and pray that you may be ready for the coming of Christ. We pray for Her Majesty the Queen and all the members of the royal family, for the Prime Minister, government, and all those who are wrestling with the coronavirus, giving thanks for the latest developments in the vaccine research and development. Let us pray for all hospitals and all hospital staff. Watch and pray that you may be ready for the coming of Christ. We pray for the world in which we live. We remember those who are hungry, the homeless and the refugee. We remember all those who through Advent and into Christmas will give a little extra. Watch and pray that you may be ready for the coming of Christ. We pray for historic royal palaces, and in particular we pray for the Tower of London, our chapels, and the Christian family of St Peter's and St John's. We remember all those on our sick list. And we remember those who have died, particularly remembering at this time Paul Gumbel, Della Howard, and Susan Doughty. Watch and pray that you may be ready for the coming of Christ. These prayers and all our prayers we bring together in the words that Jesus taught us. Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive them that trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. Watch and pray that you may be ready for the coming of Christ. Watch and wait that you may be ready for the coming of Christ. The peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. I pray your guardian angel will watch over you and those whom you love. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost be with you this day and always. Amen.